Understanding Kharif, Rabi and Zayat crops. Now this is a very interesting journey that we would have today and moving from the various seasons. Now we would understand that there is a season for sowing and then for harvesting. Sowing means when you are putting the seeds and harvesting when the crop is finally ready. So the Kharif crop, the sowing season is probably from April to June we say, and the month for harvesting is September to October. In case of Rabi, the sowing season starts from the month of October-November, that's the cold months, and harvested during the spring, the March and the April. And the Zayat crop is sown during the month of March, harvested during the month of June. Now, as we understand, within the 12 months of an year, we have different seasons that are demarcated. Now, these seasons are specific. Each of these have a specific characteristics. The Kharif and the Rabi word comes from the Arabic word. Kharif means autumn season and Rabi means spring season. So that is particular to the crops that they have. Now, looking on to each of these independently, let's first talk about Kharif crop. So as we already talked about the sowing season and the harvesting season, this is the season of monsoon. So there is a high amount of water that is required for the crops that are grown in the Kharif season. So amount of water requirement is high. Hot weather is there. So firstly, you have heavy rainfall. The second is the weather conditions are hot. The next important thing is that flowering here occurs for shorter day length. So the day length is shorter for the flowering to occur. The next important thing that we understand is the harvesting in the north, the sowing of the crop in the North India and the South India would be different. In the south, since the monsoon hits early, you would have sowing in the month of May itself. However, as you move towards North India, the sowing season is usually June, the point where you have the commencement of the monsoon season that starts, or the commencement of the monsoon season, right? Now, what are the crops that are associated with Kharif? So some of the important crops that are associated with Kharif are rice, indeed requires a lot of water. You have cotton, sugarcane, then maize, those that you enjoy during the monsoon season. So you have maize, groundnut as some of the important crops. Besides that, bajra and sorghum are the crops that are obtained during the Kharif season. The next is the Rabi season. Now, as we said, for the Rabi season, if there is unusual weather conditions with unusual rainfall patterns, that would affect the Rabi crop, because Rabi crop is a crop which is grown in the cold climate, but the germination process starts during the warmer months. So it's usually the month of October-November where you have the germination, and during the whole of the cold season you have the maturity of the crop that is seen. Also, longer day length is observed with the Rabi season for flowering. So flowering has a longer daytime that is seen in Rabi crops. Now some of the examples of the Rabi crops are indeed wheat. Then you have spices, so cinnamon, coriander, cumin are some of the examples. Then you have linseed, sunflower, gram, oat as some of the good examples for Rabi crop. So those are the crops that you have, you usually see during the Rabi cropping pattern, and barley is indeed one of the essential crops. Then you have the Zayat. Now Zayat is the summer crop that is called as, it is a season between the Kharif, after the closure of the Rabi and before the starting of the Kharif crop. So between Rabi and Kharif, you have the Zayat season that occurs. Now Zayat crops are usually cucumber, bitter gourd, and then watermelon. So most of the fruits and vegetables grow during the Zayat period. So these are some of the three important crops that we have seen, the cropping seasons that we have seen, a very, very important and essential part. So if you look onto the wheel here, we have the Kharif season, followed by the Rabi season, followed by the Zayat season, and you have all the months that are covered here. So the individual crops, as you can see here, are important, and the specificity of each of the seasons we have already discussed. We would be bringing many such other important topics for you. Stay tuned. Have a wonderful day ahead.